96,000 mile range update. Yes, I'm over because I had to charge up on a high-powered wall charger. Couldn't sit at the supercharger much longer. So it is 77 degrees out. And we charged up to 255 rated miles. Surprisingly, this has really been kind of stable for a while now. Although, again, I am still on firmware 8.1, one of the very last ones. And Tesla's been nerfing all the newer firmwares. So starting June 2019 on firmware 9 through... It's now June 20th, 1 year since they started nerfing these packs on the older cars. If I were to update to firmware 10, there's a great chance that I might lose some, or artificially lose pack capacity, as well as my supercharging speeds would be slowed significantly more. My Model X is already seeing that, and that's at about 20,000 less miles on this vehicle, and supercharged significantly less. Let's put it this way. My 90D that we're sitting in now, I could go 0 to 100% at a supercharger in about 2 hours. My 75D Model X, due to the firmware that Tesla's been putting out, takes 3.5 hours to go from 0 to 100%. If I was on this firmware back when I bought my Model X used and drove it from Boston to Milwaukee, the additional charging time, now that I did that whole drive in less than 24 hours from pickup to arriving home, and that drive would have taken 10 to 15 hours longer for charge time than it did. So that would have added 50 to 60% longer drive time on the new firmware. So anyways, that's a whole different video subject. So we're going to go down here and look at TM Spy. Now, we got car thinks pack capacity is 74.3 kilowatt hours, and it thinks it charged to 74.2. Now, that did say 74.3 when charge completed. I had to complete charge on the high-powered wall charger, so things cooled off a bit. Balance is 4 millivolts. That is absolutely excellent and much better than my Model X's 60 millivolt difference, which, of course, I'm told is normal. Lifetime discharge, 44.298 megawatts. Lifetime charge, 48.047 megawatts. That's a shit ton. Going down, everything looks pretty good and pretty balanced and even there. Car reports that I charged to 99.7%. Of course, again, that could have something to do with the pack cooling off. Because current temperature of the pack has a high of 83.6 and a low of 82.2. I did my best. Excuse me, got a hair in my mouth. I did my best to charge at the 80 amp. I got current limited to 60 amp because of a very oversubscribed transformer and everybody running their air conditioners because it was like 90 something yesterday. So let's pop out this dongle and pop in this dongle. I ordered a splitter so I could have both dongles plugged in at the same time. I haven't gotten it yet. It's coming from China, of course. Scan my Tesla. Reading Bluetooth. Blah, 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 blah. Let's see if we can get rid of some of this glare. Yeah, that didn't help. Less glare from a black shirt. There we go. So, balance, temperatures, we want charge total, discharge total. Charge cycles, there we go. This vehicle, this battery is currently at 647 charge cycles. There we go. Discharge cycles is 596. My theory is things are going to really start tanking just as I hit about 1,000. That's just my theory based on other 18650 cells. Of course, not with Tesla's magic sauce in the mix there. And let's just take a look at charge totals. Lifetime DC charging 34.416 megawatts. AC charging 7.907 megawatts. That's a lot of megawatts. And then, of course, regen. That's a cool one. Regen. So far, the car has regenerated 5.723 megawatts of power. If you think about it, that's a lot of money worth of power that has been regenerated. It's a good subject for another video. Oh, there we go. Okay, I gotta go pick up some orders. Adios.